Hello and welcome to the earnings update of Muthoot Finance Limited and its subsidiaries for the quarter 3 of this financial year 2021. At the outset, let me wish you all good health and request you to observe the government safety guidelines issued for our benefit. Muthoot Finance showcased a stellar performance this quarter for the year 2021. We have had a historic growth in these challenging times. Our consolidated loan assets under management has crossed 55,800 crores, and our consolidated profit after tax has reached 2,795 crores. The net worth of our company stands at 14,400 crores. We continue to have a bank branch of 5,413 branches, and the most important, we serve 200,000 customers every day. The flagship company of the group, Muthoot Finance, has crossed the 50,000 crore in gold loan this quarter. This is really a tremendous achievement, and it's the first time the company has reached the 50,000 crore mark. Another feature which is really outstanding is our growth of 8,900 crores in gold loans in the last 9 months. In these challenging COVID times, your company has been able to grow this good in this quarter thanks to the support of all our customers, all our employees, and all other stakeholders in this respect. As of date, the company has grown 22% AUM for these 9 months. We had given a guidance of 15% growth for the full year. We have already crossed 22%. And I'm sure by the end of the year, we should be able to reach at least 25 to 26% AUM growth. Going forward also, our company will be able to grow good at least a 15% in the next coming years also. Although we always say a 15%, we will always be able to overachieve that. Last year, we targeted for 15 and we grow by 22. This year also, we targeted by 15, we have already crossed 22%, and I'm sure we will be able to cross 25 to 26%. The growth of the company in all these respects are good. Coming to the subsidiaries, the microfinance Belstar has grown well in this quarter and this year. It has come back to its pre-COVID days, and today its assets under management stands at 2,800 plus crores. Its collection efficiency is more than 98%, better or equal to all the other similar companies in the microfinance sector. The other subsidiary, the Muthoot Homefin, has been going on a slow pace. We have been calibrated our growth, and we have been going slow on new acquisitions in these three quarters. So our AUM has come down from 2,000 to 1,800. But this company has much better prospects in the quarters to come, and we should see it coming back to its pre-COVID days after another 2 or 3 quarters, when the market and the building construction industry also is better. Now coming to Muthoot Money, our subsidiary doing the vehicle finance. Because of the challenging times in these COVID times, as well as other market changes, we have been able going slow on the growth, and our growth has been almost steady, and we have our AUM of 420 crores. Here also, the company plans to wait for another 2-3 quarters before going back to its past glory. The two subsidiaries, the vehicle finance as well as the affordable home finance, are close to our customers, because our gold loan customers are the potential customers for these two businesses, and we see great synergy between these two as lead generators and also keeping our customers more into Muthoot by offering them these products which otherwise they were taking or giving from some other companies. So going forward, not only the gold loan business, but after 2-3 quarters, our home finance as well as the vehicle finance will also start yielding good results. So also our Sri Lankan subsidiary Asia Asset Finance, it is now gradually turning into a gold loan company. As of date, it has more than 40% of its total assets in gold loan. In the next 2 years, just like Muthoot Finance, it will also become a gold loan centric company, having more than 90% of its assets in gold loan. The insurance subsidiary is also continuing to do well and earning good profits for the company.
Hello and welcome to the earnings update of Muthoot Finance Limited and its subsidiaries for quarter 3 financial year 2021. The consolidated gross loan assets of Muthoot Finance Limited and its subsidiaries stood at ₹55,799 crores at the end of Q3 financial year 2021, compared to ₹43,435 crores at the end of the same period in the previous financial year, a year-on-year growth of 28% in gross loan assets. Muthoot Finance and its subsidiaries reported a consolidated profit after tax of ₹2,795 crores at the end of the first 9 months of financial year 2021, a year-on-year growth of 20% in profits. The gross loan assets of Muthoot Finance Limited, the flagship company, stood at ₹50,390 crores at the end of Q3 financial year 2021, compared to ₹38,498 crores at the end of Q3 financial year 2020, a 31% year-on-year increase. Muthoot Finance reported a standalone profit of ₹2,726 crores for the first 9 months of financial year 2021, compared to ₹2,203 crores for the same period in financial year 2020, a 23% year-on-year increase in profits. Muthoot Finance has a wide national footprint with 4,632 plus branches across the length and breadth of India. The digital initiatives of Muthoot Finance is gaining traction, with 20.3% of our gold loan customers now transacting online. New digital conveniences for our customers include loan repayment options through Paytm and PhonePe apps. In July 2020, we launched the Loan at Home product, an app-based service through which customers can now open a gold loan from the comfort of their home. The app has been downloaded over 10,000 times. Muthoot Finance has a strong net worth of ₹14,178 crores as at the end of Q3 financial year 2021. Muthoot Finance has stable sources of funding that include a mix of highly rated secured non-convertible debentures, bank borrowings and commercial paper issues. Muthoot Finance enjoys the highest credit ratings amongst gold loan companies from the leading domestic and international credit rating agencies. Muthoot Finance's average gold loan per branch stands at ₹10.71 crores at the end of Q3 financial year 2021. Muthoot Finance has a highly liquid portfolio with average monthly disbursements and collections of ₹102 billions and ₹90 billions respectively. With regard to the safety of our gold loan portfolio, from the lender's perspective, Muthoot Finance enjoys a margin of safety on loans of 35%, and from the borrower's perspective, the equity of the borrower in the gold ornaments, net of loans availed, stands at 46%. Muthoot Finance maintains a capital adequacy ratio of 26.38%, well above the statutory limit. Muthoot Finance has a skilled workforce of 25,893 employees at the end of Q3 financial year 2021. On to the subsidiaries. Asia Asset Finance PLC Sri Lanka had a loan AUM of ₹13,309 million at the end of Q3 financial year 2021 and reported a profit after tax of ₹18 million for the first 9 months of financial year 2021. the loan AUM of Muthoot Homefin India Limited stood at ₹1,880 crores at the end of Q3 financial year 2021. Muthoot Homefin reported a profit after tax of ₹7.5 crores for the first three quarters of financial year 2021. Muthoot Insurance Brokers Private Limited collected premiums of ₹257 crores in the first 9 months of financial year 2021 by selling 19,98,871 policies. The gross loan AUM of Belstar Microfinance Limited stood at ₹2,885 crores at the end of Q3 financial year 2021. Belstar reported a profit after tax of 35 crores for the first 9 months of financial year 2021. Muthoot Money's gross loan AUM stood at ₹421 crores at the end of Q3 financial year 2021.
Overall, our company has been able to do well this quarter also. Once again, thanks to all our customers, all our staff, all our lending banks, all our customers for gold loan, as well as the investments who have supported us all through. And I'm sure with all your support and the hard work of our dedicated staff, we should be able to do well in the coming years also. Thank you. Jai Hind.